Hello everyone, welcome to Global Government News. Today is Monday, September 19th, 2011, and I'm Darko. This is part three of this news bulletin. I thought I was only going to do two, but I'll just do three because I still have more news to get to. My website is ggnonline.com for new listeners, www.ggnonline.com. Also, ddarko2012 is my YouTube channel, so go in there and subscribe, and you can check out all the playlists. Otherwise, you can follow me by email, entering your email address here, and everything I post here on ggnonline.com will go to you in your email box. So if you haven't seen this poll yet, I'll just go ahead and read it quickly. How likely is it that the standards of living will increase for the serf classes in the next decade? So far, 100% of the voters are saying below 50% chance that their standard of living will increase. Okay, so let's move on here. South Florida. Oh yeah, don't forget to check all the links in the YouTube's video description. So all the links and headlines for these articles will be available in YouTube's video description. So I highly recommend that you check them out, these articles. I kind of just give a brief overview in my comment usually. South Florida cop, we can videotape you, but you don't have the right to videotape us. So in a police force of less than 20 officers, it's not that difficult to be named Officer of the Month. But Take-Home Beach Officer Robert Ruggiero, who was recently named Officer of the Month in a tiny town in northeast corner of Miami-Dade, and it goes on here, and it says that he was confronted a citizen the other day who was recording him during a traffic stop. So he informed a citizen that recording cops without their consent is a felony in Florida. A felony, like that? Always double standards. You know, the slaves can't have tinted windows, but they can because they got to hide their faces. Because they're criminals, says here. Ruggiero was so convinced of this myth that he even happily provided his name and badge number to the citizen, urging him to take that to his lawyer. Turns out the citizen is a Miami-based contributor to Cop Block, and regular photography is not a crime reader. He knows exactly what his rights are. So it goes in here, says to see the actual incident, started video at 2:15 mark, where you hear Ruggiero say the following: it's a felony. And then he goes on and he says, he's quoted as saying, you see, the law says that we can videotape you, but you can't have the right to videotape us without our consent or record us. And then he goes on and says, if I ever run into you at a traffic stop, if I stop you and you audio tape me, or videotape me and you don't have my consent, I promise you I will arrest you for a felony and I will battle it out in court. And maybe it isn't for it. Not really sure 100%, but this individual seems to be pretty savvy in that area. But I've covered articles here in the past month, two articles, but one specifically about an African-American woman that actually took it to court, and she won. And, of course, the case was whether it was legal or not to video record or whatever, audio record a police officer, and they said no, it wasn't. So I'm not sure I can't remember what state it was in, but I'm sure if you do a quick scroogle or start smart page or start page search, you'll find it. Keep moving here. Group urges the U.S. to adopt electronic ID cards for citizens as the Obama administration works on a set of voluntary online credentials for American web surfers. Some technologists say the government should examine Estonia's mandatory electronic identity card as a model, so that people like Darko here, I don't usually refer to myself in what, the first person, whatever it is, but he will be gone. So my ID will be revoked. So it says here, the CIA really wants to, and that's the whole point. If you get an online ID, that's the first step to banning individuals. See, they could just ban certain individuals, but they don't want to seem like the aggressors. So they make crimes, they make all these laws so that they can criminalize everybody for anything that they do. And if you're not kind to the powers that be, to the state and whatnot, you know, they're going to revoke your license. So that's what it's all about, just like gun permits and licenses and all that. And so that they can revoke it if you're not a good slave. The CIA really wants to make Hollywood's next blockbuster. So it goes in here and it says the Department of Defense and just about every other branch of the military has an entertainment industry liaison similar to the CIA's. So yeah, you can go in there and check that out. But it says the scripts we are getting are only the writer's idea of how the Department of Defense operates. And it goes in there and says, we make sure the Department of Facilities and people are portrayed in the most accurate and positive light possible. Okay, this is the same bullshit that you hear about as far as trolls, online trolls that are military. And they'll say, oh, we got to make sure that they... that people, when they talk about the Air Force, that it's keeping up with the traditions in the honor of the United States Air Force, and that's like I said, it's bullshit, is what it is. And then they have basically these trolls, these guys that get paid. It's their job to go through a little flow chart. I've seen it, and then eventually they figure out what they're gonna do with people on comment boards and that, and they have a whole system to it from A to B. You know, there's actually one where they say, oh, I'm not going to respond. But either way, I'm going to stick with this here. So it's the same thing. You know, back in the day, as a former Marine, I've said this before, but I am a former Marine, and I know uniforms, and especially with Marine Corps. And I've seen so many movies that don't portray uniforms correctly. They're always ass backwards and things missing and out of place and just little things, you know what I'm saying? And if the military really was involved in that, then there wouldn't be those inaccuracies in movies. No, their thing is the Pentagon. It's based on the Pentagon is to implant stories that they basically want to imprint on the population. It's psychological warfare is what it is. And they want to push something, some kind of agenda, whatever it is, get a consensus. Then they'll just portray certain things in a certain light. That's what they really mean by this. And of course, entertainment in Hollywood is the biggest brainwashing programming complex there is. So it makes sense that the state, which is used by the powers that be, the social engineers, use the government and Hollywood as a means to imprint and program thousands, millions of people to think the way they want to think. And well, that's right, because entertainment, you're entering something, and basically they're entering your mind, and they're doing damage to so many people. It's just really, really sick, because most people let their guard down. So, you know, and that's very unfortunate. But they do have a liaison, the CIA, in the entertainment industry. So, and yeah, you can go in there and check that out. And it says includes in the other article, 25 years later, how Top Gun made America love war. And yeah, it's pretty crazy, because it goes in there and says that when they came up with this movie, that Navy enlistment actually spiked, and there wasn't really much war really going on in the 80s. It says here, updates improve Facebook and Twitter connections. So Facebook members will soon be able to pipe their profile directly to a connected Twitter account. And that makes sense because, well, we all know that DARPA and CIA basically brought us Facebook to create humongous profiles on people, individuals, slaves. And that's why they call it Facebook. It's a book on your profile, on your personality. And Twitter is just another way to track the slaves. And it was also used by Twitter for using slaves to basically locate other bad slaves, dissenting slaves. And they did a little balloon thing, like I've already talked about this in New York City. Spot the balloons and that, and get a prize. And of course, it was, what was it, MIT that won. So, of course, it wasn't the regular slaves. It was the university that helped fund it. So either way, we're gonna keep moving here. Another mass die-off, millions of fish found dead in China. So 2 days before the massive 9.0 magnitude earthquake struck off the coast of Japan, it says here, millions of dead fish were found mysteriously blanketing waters of the King Harbor Marina in Redondo Beach, California. And so this turns out that millions of dead fish were recently discovered floating in China's river. Just coincidence or a sign of worse things to come? So go in there and check that out. So it says here, Japanese government to invite foreigners who have large Facebook and Twitter accounts to Tohoku so that they can tell their followers Japan is safe. So see, like I said, Twitter, Facebook, being used what it's supposed to be used for. And that's right. They're going to get people from overseas to disseminate information via the social media, such as Facebook and Twitter, as part of a countermeasure against baseless rumors that have damaged sales of Japanese agricultural products and tourism industry. Now, so many people have stepped down in the Japanese government. I honestly, I don't think there's anything more that they could have done to prevent it, except for maybe not have nuclear power. But then, well, let's see. They don't have natural gas. They don't have oil. They really don't have any energy. And if you want to try to keep up with the powers that other powers that be to countries, well, you're going to have to go with the nuclear power or solar power or whatever. I mean, they could have gone with that. I'm not for nuclear, but they did. And so, yeah, a lot of them are stepping down, and it is pretty bad down there. It says here, gender equality, right thing, smart economy, economics, says the World Bank. So it's here, gender equality matters in its own right, and it's also smart economics, as countries that create better opportunities and conditions for women and girls can raise productivity, improve outcomes for children, the World Bank said in a report released on Sunday prior to its upcoming annual meetings. So I've already talked about the female energy being hijacked by the powers that be, the Luciferians, the dark side, and they've turned it and morphed it into this ugly feminine energy. And so the way I see it is the outcome for children is not going to be better. Whether it's a woman, preferably a woman, or a man, just one of them that's home with their children and being homeschooled or something like that, I think that's the best way to improve outcomes for children. But just telling females that they're males and that they need to take the role as the breadwinner, that just confuses everything in the natural order of the universe. That's my own personal opinion. So it's not better for them. You're going to have a bunch, and you know what? You're basically going to have a high divorce rate, and you're going to have a bunch of children that are spoiled, that they hate their parents, or parents that don't know how to be parents. And look, you have that right now, right? So I don't know. But, you know, usually most parents aren't going to go for that, like a female or something like that, because they want to live their own life and they want to be independent and all that and get an education and, like, you know, certain family members and that, pull their children from, basically not pull it, but they were homeschooling their children and they were great and wonderful, and now they just dumped them in a re-education camp. A school, public school, whatever, and that's so that she can pursue college, and that's after she left her husband. So this is what I'm talking about, and all of you guys have seen this, and this is just, I'm talking about my own personal experience, what I've seen in my family, so I know that it's right. But maybe when I'm dead, I'll find out that I'm wrong. Maybe everything I said was wrong, so I don't know. You got to make your own decision. But Tasmania Parliament first to vote in favor of same-sex marriage, so going to go on and legalize that. I don't even know why it has to be legalized. People just won't do it, but by doing it, they promote it. So, and that's another belief of mine. So here, children as young as 4 reprimanded for racist behavior. So more than 20,000 under 11s were punished for racist and homophobic behavior in schools last year, according to research. So schools are obliged to report all hate speech incidents to local authorities as part of the 2000 Race Relations Act. So this is about diversity. This is about the social engineers. And, you know, I saw an article today with the Wall Street Journal, and it basically said that what? And they were talking about social engineering, as was the title of it. And it was talking about how blacks actually like to stay with blacks, and Asians usually like to stay with Asians, and whites usually stay with whites. That's just the natural order of things. But no, they have to force this diversity on us. They have to force this equality on us. And that's what I think is just the Luciferians, and they're fucking everything up. So, and we got to try to maintain our sanity through all of this. Talking sex with your kids, a bold new initiative to introduce sex education in primary schools being viewed as a sign of progress by many in the nation, where traditionally the subject is, ooh, taboo, see, because that's what the traditional order of. Again, just like homosexuality, this is to promote this. This is to promote people who aren't going to have actual bonds and relationships to the day they die. This is so that they can be very promiscuous at a very young age, and there's no family, and there's no family, there's no morality in society. Study shows increased mammograms result in more, all right, I'm going to try this, mastectomies. So anyway, either way, it increases the risk for more cancer. So women's cancer reaches 2 million. Of course, that's the plan. Mondale's daughter dies at 51 of brain cancer this week. Then JFK's niece dies at 51 of a heart. Then Brian Urlacher's mom died as well, a third woman who died at 51 of cancer. Pesticide exposure. And don't forget those two crashes. There was not only a West Virginia or the Reno crash, but also West Virginia. So those were ritual sacrifices. I'm sorry to break it to you. Pesticide exposure in expectant mothers causes lower IQ in children. China sets new world record with hybrid GMO rice yield. Good for them. Flooding forces 300,000 to evacuate in South China. And researchers are going to actually test artificial volcanoes for geoengineering the climate. So never mind those big pesky tic-tac-toe chemtrails above you. This GGN. Thank